Let's get our regression equation from the last episode. So the equation was teacher hat equals 0.468 plus 0.005414 and 628 times pop. Okay, now please keep in mind that we scaled our data in thousands, so one unit of both variables equals 1000 in reality. Okay, now this number right here, 0.468, this is our constant alpha, and this huge number over here, this is the beta coefficient for our independent variable pop. So this is the coefficient for the population. We already know how to calculate the estimated number of teachers for a given quantity of population. But this equation tells us much more than that. It also says that for an increase of one unit of pop, teacher increases by 0.0054 units. In plain English, that would mean if you increase the population by 1,000 or one unit, you'd also increase the number of teachers of 0.0054,000 or 5.4 teachers. So if you increase this by one unit, you also increase teachers by 0.0054146 to 8 units. This is what this equation says. And that's how we estimate the strength of the relationship. I know that it might be a bit complicated because I scaled the data in thousands. So let's imagine another example. Imagine we have a simple linear regression model with one dependent and one independent variable. The dependent variable, so the, let me get another color. The dependent variable would be, let's say this is, let's say this is, spending on leisure activity. So this is household spending on leisure activity in dollars, for example. And we have an independent variable, and that is household income. So household income in dollars, for example. Okay, first of all, how would the plot or the scatter plot look like? So it might look something like this. Well, in reality it wouldn't, but let's assume it would look like this. Okay, so it would be a positive correlation. And with an increase in household income comes an increase in spending on leisure activity. Now we might put the data into R and it'll give us back the following regression equation. So imagine you've done some research, you put the data into R, and R gives you back the following regression equation. It says, okay, spending hat equals 10, this is the constant, 10, plus 0.2 times income. Okay, this is the regression equation. What does that equation say? It has two parts, the constant and the it has the constant again and the coefficient for the income variable, for the household income. The constant 10 tells us that if income is 0, $10 will be spent on leisure activity. Well, since that doesn't make any sense, we can ignore the constant. The thing of interest is the coefficient for income. So this right here, the beta coefficient. This thing is of interest. It says that if you increase income by $1, leisure spending will be increased by 20 cents because this is 0.2. So if you increase the household income by $1, the spending of this household for leisure activity will increase by 20 cents or by $0.2. That's pretty interesting. We figured out the relationship between household income and spending on leisure activity. Well, keep in mind that it is just a simple example for demonstration purposes, and I would doubt that it represents reality in any way. First of all, it wouldn't be linear, for example. This wouldn't be a linear scatter plot. Okay. One really important thing at the end. What would happen if that coefficient, so if the beta coefficient, would be equal to zero? So it would be absolutely equal to zero. What would happen? Well, pretty easy. There would be no relationship. The increase in income has absolutely no effect. If the coefficient is equal to zero, it would have absolutely no effect on spending on leisure activities. But be careful, the distance to zero doesn't say anything about the magnitude of the underlying relationship. The coefficient depends on the scale of our data. That's the reason why I divide the original data in our population and number of teachers example by 1000. The coefficient for population in the not divided example was extremely small, with several zeros after the decimal separator. But that didn't say anything about the underlying relationship. That is still the same after dividing by 1000, which is pretty strong, as we know. The coefficients are so extremely small because the coefficient tells you by how much the dependent variable, the number of teachers, increases or decreases if you increase the independent variable by one unit. Now, why would the coefficient be so extremely small in our teachers and population example? Because if I wouldn't divide my data by 1000, what you would say is, if you increase the population by just one inhabitant, the number of teachers would increase by so and so much. And now, one additional inhabitant, more or less in states of millions of people, really has no huge effect on the number of teachers in total. So don't make the mistake and think that small coefficients equal small relationships. It always depends on the scale of your data. There's another measure if we want to know whether there's a relationship or not and how strong that relationship is. If you want to know what the measure is, check out the next episode.